So thank you for joining in, Yee Jin. It's a pleasure having you on board. And this is our week 10. You are our second guest host for this live session. After last week, we had a Merdeka special. So this week, without further ado, this is something, you know, Happy Malaysia Day in advance to all those who are who's going to tune in to this. We wish everybody Happy Malaysia Day and thank you for tuning in for our session. So just a brief run through to all of y'all who are tuning in. This is how we run the Axe Sharpening session, and this is the topics that we've covered so far. If you can see, it's about giving. We've covered about giving and receiving feedback, and that is by Sheila Heen. She's an incredible speaker on how we should give and receive feedback. And we've covered also on topics of law of growth. There is 16 law of growth. So with this group that I'm doing, we're only going to cover about 6. So we haven't covered all of it. We've covered 2 so far. Now we talk about how to fail forward. Failing forward by Susie Levine. She's incredible. You can check that on YouTube as well. We covered the Golden Circle by Simon Sinek. If you don't know, he's really incredible as well. He talks about the why. We talk about how to listen, and then we talk about attitude. And last week's session, of course, is the life story. So this week, as you can see the arrow, we're going to cover on the topic of what is chiropractor and how can we help. And that will be, you know, none other than Yee Jin, who's going to, you know, give us some insights to what is chiropractor and how they can help. And I think that's really something going to be very useful and something that we all can learn together as a group here tonight. So the rest are the topics that, you know, that we are going to cover over the coming weeks. So for those of you who, you know, like to tune in, you can use the same link to join in for our sessions. And basically, the sessions will start off, just a quick rundown. The sessions basically starts off with, you know, greetings, and then we start off with a question, Q&A, discussion, pre-questions before the video, and then we watch a video, and then we do some discussions. So that's how basically our Monday evening talks run, or our Axe Sharpening session runs. So without further ado, I'm gonna introduce you. Our speaker, of course, is none other than Dr. Khoo Yee Jin. And how I met Dr. Khoo Yee Jin was through church. It's incredible. I knew her since quite young, I think. I think about, what, at least 8 years growing up. And to see her growth from where she was to today is just remarkable. And I thought, you know, stories that can be very impactful, stories of how she... how each and every one of us have a very important role of how we deal with challenges, how we come out. I'm pretty sure Deborah, Tracy, all of y'all have incredible stories that y'all would have shared as well with, and Dr. Khoo also would have learned a couple of things from you guys. I always say that, a lot of my friends will always say that, why do you always hang out with your dad's friends? Why do you hang out with, why don't you hang out with us? I said, no, I do hang out with you guys, but sometimes I like to hang out with the adults, because when you hang out with the older ones, you get experience from them. And the older ones hang out with the younger ones because the older one gets creativity. So when you mix both of that, you get creativity and experience. That's a big win for everybody. So those of you tuning in, remember, it's nothing wrong. You're going to get a lot of insights of wisdom, right? So really, thank you, Deborah, Tracy, all of you joining in. And so that's for me how I knew Dr. Khoo Yee Jin growing up from church. And it's really, really, her story is just also very remarkable. And that's why tonight when I heard of what she was doing on chiropractor, this is something that we all can learn together as well. Yeah. Oh, I forgot the picture is there. Forgot to press that. gotta show that picture, right? Because it's a professional look. Okay, wow. It's really good. Yeah, really, really good on you. Yeah, really, really incredible. So for everybody else, Joyce and those who are tuning in, my friends and everybody, Dr. Khoo actually is you work in Peng An Medical in this. Is it Peng An Medical? Did I pronounce it correct? Peng An?
Oh, actually, so I'm an independent contractor working in the TCM clinic, but it's a different license, so I don't have a signage basically. So currently the signage looks like this outside, and it's a really huge signage, like this size kind of thing on the shop. So my chiropractic department would be, it's actually called JC Chiropractic. But if you want to locate me, you better look for this sign, because otherwise you can't find me.
Right, so just for everybody, you know, the clue, Peng An Medical Sungai Bahar is in TJ, right? Is it in Uptown?
SS2,
sorry, not Uptown, SS2. So you just have to Google it on the website, and if you guys are looking for something, you know, to do your chiropractor, you know who to look for. Look for Dr. Khoo Yee Jin. She's in SS2. And for those people who knows Dr. Khoo and who goes to church, go to the SS2 one and support our friends, okay? Don't go to other ones. Near church, otherwise not. Now you are supposed to support friend, you'll go other one. Sorry, okay. Joking. You need to practice grace, because this is grace. I'm not practicing grace enough. But yeah, without further ado, maybe before I dive into the questions and all, Dr. Khoo, would you like to say a few things before we go into our session? Would you like to say anything?
I'll just introduce a little bit about myself first. Yeah. I'm Dr. Khoo. You can call me Yee Jin as well, casually. I'm a chiropractor and I worked for about 2 years already, and I graduated from MIT University from Australia.
Thank you for that brief intro. I think I should have left that to her, because that's you know, it's better to let some people leave it to the person to tell all of them. I'd rather not cover everything, right? It's not very like fun to take everything off. But without further ado, I think we'll dive into the first question, and then Dr. Khoo will share screen about a few things about herself. And so I think this is generally the first question we're gonna just ask her. So my first question for you, Dr. Khoo, is firstly, how did chiropractic came about for you, and why the profession?
Okay, so I'll say a few words first before I share the video. Let me share screen. Give me a thumbs up if you see my screen. Answer for question one. Okay, cool. So actually, I have scoliosis. I was diagnosed from it when I was 14 years old. And I consulted many specialists during that time, orthopedic surgeons, Chinese physicians, all the other alternative methods as well. And then from there, I do get some certain results from physiotherapy treatment, but then because of financial situation, I couldn't continue my physiotherapy treatment. And also, I have also suffered from back pain due to trying so many methods. I've tried braces for my back, tried shoes for my back as well, shoes to support my pelvic, and also a lot of like massages, then all the bone settings as well, and a lot of extreme like adjustment as well. I tried everything, and I have back pain from my scoliosis or because I tried so many things, you know, we don't know lah. Then my now chiropractic mentor, quietly, very low profilely, he actually fixed my back pain of 3 to 4 years within, can tell you it is definitely within 1 month he fixed my back pain. A 3 to 4 years pain, he fixed it. I'm pretty sure it was within 1 to 2 months like that. So it definitely makes me curious, you know, what is chiropractic? And that is definitely why I chose chiropractic, because, you know, not all profession can do this kind of thing, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, it's such a such a long period of pain, right? And then suddenly, like, in such a short period of time, can fix so fast, ma. So he must have done something right, lah. So I'm gonna test to. I'm gonna also show you a video to answer your question as well. Everyone understand a bit of Mandarin, right? The whole thing is Mandarin, eh? Okay. You see if it's loading, Jesse.
Well,
oh, I need to reshare again.
No one can make you feel inferior without your consent.
Yeah. Let me reshare.
No worries. Just a disclaimer for everyone. Sometimes the video might be laggy, and that's just because that's how the Zoom operates. But if you can hear. It's usually you can hear the voice much clearer than the video, but yeah.
No one can make you feel inferior without your consent. 我叫 邱一清，我是一名脊椎矫正师。我是想从事这份职业，是因为我以前14岁的时候有脊椎侧弯。过后我们就遇到很多不同的医生、铁打师傅。这种各种不同的职业的人，我们全部都去看了，也花了很多钱。过后，我姐姐一个好朋友，她也是我的，算是好像 mentor 这样子啊。她说要来见我，她讲我要帮助的妹妹，背痛超过3-4年，你知道吗？她竟然在短期内帮我解除疼痛，过后。他开始要跟我说，其实脊椎侧弯是不能矫正直的，可是我们人体是可以去适应，去 adapt， 我还是可以过正常人的生活。然后从那时候我就开始好像很积极。有一年哦，记得那一年，我妈妈跟我一起努力。那一年，我们每一天除了。真的整齐的时候，我们都一定会去游泳，一点都不会放弃。塞车，jam 也不会阻止我们。下大雨就换一天，这样换去早上。总之，我妈就跟我讲，不可以放弃就对了。365天 ，minus 那个星期，都一定要去游泳。你知道我在游泳的时候看到我妈这样子，就是像傻傻的等我，你知道吗？他只是看着我游泳，我们也是吵架。吵架过后，他就跟我讲要继续游。那我就觉得哇，我妈很坚强一下。过后，因为我这一个脊椎侧弯，就我哥哥姐姐也很安慰我。其实我是最小的在家里，不想让我的父母觉得我以后自己照顾不了自己。我的脊椎调理师也是很难说服我。接受我有脊椎侧弯，所以我就决定我要去做一个脊椎矫正师，我要去找一个答案，到底真的是可以矫正没有，还是不可以矫正？深造了5年，然后再加上现在做工2年了，在大学时候在读那个脊椎侧弯的那个洞顶的时候，我就已经告诉我自己接受吧。人生的道路其实就是不是一条直路啊。就是弯哦，就好像脊椎侧弯这样子弯哦，你会跌倒啊，可是你要站起来。澳洲深造的时候，我记得我有去做一个兼职，就我们在球场上帮那些运动员，哇，他们的运动员，我跟你讲，他们的那个。腿啊，简直是的 size 我的头。我每一次帮他们那个按肌肉的时候，他们都会跟我讲，哎，不过我大力要比较大力一点。可是他们会很鼓励你，就是我觉得是外国人的很好的一个这个 quality。人生功课，医学方面我可以帮助到人，但我的目标一定是 one at a time。做好一个了过后，可能那一个人可以帮3个，不要看小的跑好坏。
OK， Yep， That's it for question one. You're mute.
Yeah， you know, just from that session, I might not have picked up much. I mean, it's quite a lot for me to pick up from Mandarin, but I roughly got about it. I'm a little bananaish. But you know, based from what you just shared in the first story, I just wrote it down. It's the first thing already. Just your first answer, you already just, you know, my heart has been moved, because I realized from that what you just answered, why you did it. And I think it's a lot of stuff for us, all of us here today, to learn. And one of it is, you know, God can use the pain that you go through and turn it into a strength. And I think that's what I got out of this. I don't know, something just felt in me that God can turn your pain that you're going through the season, right, and turn it into a strength. And I think for us who are going through challenges, I think for some of us, my feeling is that despite the challenges you're going through, I'm pretty sure when you come out of it, God is using you through that challenges and making you stronger, come out of it even stronger from whatever you're going through. And so I think that, you know, the first thing, I really touched my heart that when you showed that clip of how you went through your journey, I think that's really incredible, Dr. Khoo. And I know I'm calling you Dr. Khoo, but you know, it's just, you know, addressing you, but I know you as Yee Jin, but you know, I still have to, you know, used to it. But yeah, you know, but yeah, it's really, really, I think it's really, really touching. And that's what I felt through the first question to this that you know, you asked, how that I just asked you guys, asked you about, you know. Wow, I could just, you know, ramble and talk about how good this first question is without going the next questions, because there's a couple, but you know, that really says so much, really, the beginning. I just, you know, when I watched that video, I don't know how many of the others, I just felt touched. No, I just felt really touched, the emotions to it, and it's that realness that we want to bring to each and everyone, and that's what I'm trying to bring through this act sharpening, to everyone, being real with one another, with having this open space, open conversation where we can talk about things without being judged, without being talked down, because this is a space where not many people have, you know, around. And by opening this kind of space, you allow people to be real and to learn and grow as well. Wow, thank you, Dr. Khoo. So we move on to the next question, but unless you have anything else to add on, would you like to add? Okay, yeah, I personally don't know why I have so much things to say. Usually I'm quite...
Wow, emotions already, Jesse.
I know, right? Right, I'm usually the introvert. I'm usually the introvert, right? Because a lot of people, I don't really talk a lot. But when I tell most of my friends I'm introvert, everybody say, "Are you sure? No, you're not an introvert." But honestly,
you also grow a lot.
Change happens, right?
This is a drama, guys. By the way,
a drama, maybe a drama, perhaps, yeah. But yeah. I'm just feeling the emotion, it's so real.
Okay.
Anyways, yeah, before we get carried on with too much emotions and I drag on the whole session, let's not get into it. We'll go into the next question. And I think this is really important for my group that we are learning, right? And I emphasize that we learn a lot about things. We only know the certain things on the surface. And for example, I just say, yeah, I know what's chiropractor, they help you do your body and stuff, but do we know what do you really do deeper? Do we really understand what the function is? Do we understand why you are doing what you're doing? And with that, if we don't know why you're doing what you're doing, we don't understand what people are actually trying to do, you know, and we won't understand people even more. And so with that, I'm going to just leave the question here. With that said, Dr. Khoo, could you share with us on what and how does chiropractor help?
Yes, sure. So I'll share screen as well for this one. Okay. So So for the second question, so how can a chiropractor help? So I'll try to summarize in 3 points. The first one is alignment. Okay. The second one is pain relief and management. And the third one is diagnosis and advice. So you want to know, you know, whether I'm the right health practitioner for you. Maybe you should see a physio or a traditional Chinese medicine, or maybe an orthopedic surgeon or a specialist, or maybe a medical referral like a family doctor, or sometimes you know, so unfortunate you're someone who needs to go to the emergency department. Okay, now has it happened in my practice before? Oh, thank God, no. Okay, otherwise I'll be very stressful as well. So first one, the first point, alignment. So if you look at the slide over here, right, let's start from the head until the toe, okay? The neck over here, you can see it misaligned to the right lah. So means maybe sometimes you notice, right, every time you take photo, right, you always like misalign this part. Or maybe even if you're not taking photo, you feel like your head is not resting in the middle. There's something wrong with the joint position actually, okay? That's the misalignment we're talking about. Then after that, you look at the shoulder, there's imbalances. Sometimes it's caused by muscle, yes, but you can also consider the alignment issue, okay? Near the cervical and thoracic part of the spine. Then after that, next, we look at the pelvic. The pelvic is over here, follow my mouse here, okay? Sometimes the left side can be higher than the right side. It can come from fall. Maybe sometimes you just sit with your leg cross-legged, or you know, like, we say in Chinese, you know, we put our leg onto another leg. Maybe 5 minutes, never mind lah. But if you do that for like an hour or 2 hours, right, of course your pelvis is gonna misalign lah, okay? Or maybe you put your purse and sitting on your purse, one high, one low, right? 5 minutes is okay. But you do that for a long time, then of course you slowly misalign your pelvic lah. Or you can think of any other factors can just like misalign your pelvic. Fall on bum, of course will, right? Because such a big impact, okay? Then after that, if your pelvic is affected already, anything that is below that, right, they will follow. Look at the knees and you look at the ankle. So it can turn in, turn out, whatever, you can go beyond your imagination now, okay? But of course, I don't address dislocation or anything broken lah. That one you definitely need to go emergency department already or orthopedic. Then next, point two, pain relief and management. What am I fixing? How do I relieve your pain and manage your pain? So first one is here, normal spine, right? So and then you compare the top one and the bottom one. You can see you compare the disc over here and here. The bottom one is swollen. Can you see it? Yeah. Okay. Then, if anything swells, right, definitely got inflammation already. Confirm. Okay. Then look at the normal one, the yellow color, the nerve, and the bottom one, the yellow color become red color. That nerve is inflamed as well. Okay. Because something is contacting the nerve already. Then if you look at the back, if you look the overall bone, okay, this bone over here and the one below, you can see one is like that already, right? You know what I mean? Sengat lah. So then slowly it can misalign. Misalign, then we call it the chiropractic subluxation, or in a very simple term, mechanical joint dysfunction. Very straightforward, right? It says mechanical. So it says it is a mechanical issue, alright? So you eat painkillers, it's not gonna, it might help with the pain, but it's not gonna help you miraculously. The painkiller you eat already, wow, it will pop the bone, okay? No, not like that. Okay? So chiropractic adjusts it and provides pain relief. And the healing will come later on. You know, but is it, oh, my back pain, is it just a bone or is it just a nerve or knee? Actually, everything is involved. Because they are one unit. If you look at it, the bone is next to the disc is next to the nerve is next to the bone again, and then the bone, how they attach, right, is the muscle. So everything is affected. So please don't expect your treatment to just be gone in one session, like gone forever. It is impossible. there's a lot of things that is required to be repaired in there. Okay. Next, question three, which is diagnosis and advice. Non-mechanical problem. So if you have a look at this, this background here, you see a lot of the name of the organs, right? Right, Jessie, can you see it? Yeah, you can see spleen, the heart, the stomach, the pancreas, whatever lah, okay? So, I actually do have cases, they have internal organ issue and they come out with back pain. Well, I tell you that one is, honestly speaking well, I find it stressful personally. Cause it's like, why I listen to your story, right? Tang like tang hui, listen there, listen here, right? I don't hear any mechanical problem or cause to it. It sounds very... this is why listening to your patient is so important. Yeah, I have back pain, yes. But what is your story behind that back pain? I need to investigate. So I do have patients present with back pain and then they have intestinal issues or gastric issues. And it is really like something is going on inside. Like in very inflamed, it shows up in the muscles and the back. Sometimes people with cancer can have back pain as well. And I do see patients, I have encountered before that I actually have to say, you know, please, you go find your old oncologist doctor and find out is it due for a checkup? Because you're still within the 3 to 5 years period where it can come back, the cancer can come back. Then go check first. Then if we confirm nothing already, then okay, let's continue. Okay? So this is one of my expertise as well, due to my training in Australia lah. Okay? Mm. Anything you wanna say, Jesse?
Wow, you know, that's incredible, like really detailed all the things that you explained to us. And I think partially of this, I think answered one of one of our viewers, you know, who asked the question. I think partially answered, I think, because somehow it related to that answer, but I think later we'll get into that question. But I think that this sort of hopefully answered one of our guests who is tuning in tonight on the questions. Yeah, so I'm just gonna go back and you know, that's really incredible, you know, how you detailed that, how, you know, what you do and how does chiropractor help. And I think for all of us tuning in tonight, it really helped us know what you really do, what you truly, why you do it, and why chiropractor is also really important. And that gives me also a deeper understanding of the things that you do and who do we approach as well. And I hope the rest of you tonight tuning in, and those tuning in tonight or tuning in to this video, hopefully this answers your question. Dr. Khoo, as I said, again, I'm going to emphasize, she's in SS2. You can Google it, the place called Peng An Medicals in Yamaha. You can Google it and you can look for her there. Of course, we have her two lovely guests as well. I can also see Deborah. I think you're an anti-aging consultant. I think what more, Dr. Khoo has invited you in. So if anybody else, if you're looking for anti-aging consultant, she's right there as well. I have to, you know, because it's really incredible. Like, she got your in and I'm just amazed that, you know, Dr. Khoo got your in. So yeah, if anybody of you are looking for anti-aging, I think some of my friends who are watching this, and I think some of you had asked me about anti-aging as well. There you go. The answer is just right there. You can look for Deborah on the website. I think you can find the new skin as well on the website, and look for Deborah, make sure. Anyways, without further ado, I think, you know, thank you, Eugene, for sharing on that. I will go to the next question, you know, and I think this as well, you know, different professions have different qualifications, different kind of training, especially doctors. Now, doctors, as you know, some of them will, you know, when you graduate, you take about 3 years for certain course, but when you're a doctor, you take about 6 years at time, right? 6 or 7 years. So that's where I I'm coming in from the point of view from the audience is how long, you know, it takes a lot of training to be a chiropractor or whatever Debra is also doing, you know, to be anti-aging consultant as well. It takes some training, a lot of trainings, right? So how long does one take to be fully certified as a chiropractor? Yeah.
I had my formal training, okay, which is a university course, 5 years in RMIT University. It's in the School of Health Science in the University in Bandura, Australia. And informal training, external courses that I take on top of the university is to attend a Gone State workshop, which is a kind of chiropractic technique. It's also because mainly my chiropractic mentor, he's also from this background, that's why I followed his advice. And also I attended, I'm a bit kiasu, so before I come back, I make sure I attend the pregnancy adjusting seminar so that I'm confident to adjust pregnant women. Because once you know how to adjust adults, right, you know how to do it. So I have adjusted 2 pregnant ladies before, okay? But I don't really promote that a lot. And then I also attended this sacro-occipital technique seminar. It's a very gentle technique. It's more catered for kids and really old people that just want some relief in their meridian points in the head, basically. This is a glimpse of what 5 years RMIT training in Bandura, Australia, okay? So we are very different from medical people, okay? But I can tell you Australia training is 5 years. IMU training is 4 years. Chiropractic originated from America. Okay, let's not talk about the Chinese side, okay? That's a bit sensitive. East and West, okay? Then actually it's, in America it's 7 years or 8. It's actually very long. Yes, I don't know why so long, okay? I also don't know. I hope they shorten it already. But I think it's because when you're Malaysian, then you go there, then it's a bit longer, right? Then, so in 5 years, what I learned, actually, we're pretty similar to the medical profession, but we straight away specialize in chiropractic during the 5 years. So we don't go 5 years GP, then baru saja specialize. It's a waste of time. This is how an Australian thing plan, okay? So I learned biology of a cell, chemistry, the anatomy, your body anatomy, everything we'll learn, okay? The biomechanics over here, the mouse, follow the mouse, And my favorite, also the most challenging one, sometimes I don't know why I chari pass out to stress myself, neuroscience. Okay, neuroscience is actually, for all the medics, they know neuroscience is one of the hardest, heart as well, cardiovascular as well. Human physiology and all the chiropractic, right, I start touching people, okay, not in a weird way, in a very professional way, since year one. Okay, since year one, we need to know, all the bones, all the place, from the top to the toe, okay. This is a glimpse of year 4 and year 5. We actually learn radiology imaging, we read x-rays, but we are not allowed to produce report lah. But anyway, every time people give me an x-ray and then I read the report, right, sometimes someone, so I also need to make sure they are not wrong, or what I see is the same as what they write also. Sometimes there's mistake. But that's human error, okay? I cannot control. Then we learn Western medicine as well. We need to know all the common stuff like gout, diabetes, high blood pressure, all this. Because these are, worldwide very famous Western medical condition that's very real, that has to be addressed. That is also a cause of back pain, okay? Obesity especially, okay? Also, one of this clinical presentation across the lifespan. This one is about from 0 years old until 80 years old. From there, they were split into few categories like child, teenager, young adult, middle age, oldies. This subject teach us, right, during this kind of age group, right, what kind of common illness can be diagnosed within this age group. So then this helps to shorten your diagnostic process as well. Because we have advanced, you know, we don't have to start from scratch how to learn already. They help to, because of the advancement of technology and knowledge, right, they have taught you how to analyze things. Yeah. And also help to shape you to be a better practitioner. So then you don't have to keep guessing and guessing the diagnosis for so long. Then actually in chiropractic clinical practice 1, 2, 3, 4, if you notice over here, during my 5th year we touch on some pediatric stuff, so which is kid stuff, touch here and there, and also some pregnant women exercises, like how they can protect their back without, you know, just this big stomach there, try not to break their back lah, okay, when they're pregnant. I'm just kidding. Okay, so yeah, all this, I think this is pretty comprehensive, right, to see what my chiropractic training is in Australia. Right, Jesse?
That's a lot. Like, I'm like, goodness, like, for some of us, we just, you know, 2 years done, but I look at yours, oh my goodness, it's like five. And, you know, this tells me what you've gone through is like a lot, 5 years. Imagine, I can think of all the doctors, the medical profession who study for 7 to 8 years. It's not easy. And this really, you know, just by having you share with us a glimpse of what you went through, but 5 years, correct? If I'm not wrong, you just, yeah. 5 years is actually very long. Can you imagine the doctors who had to go and study for 7 to 8 years? I can just imagine how long that, you know, just to graduate 8 years, you know. But you really do see, like how you showed us here, it really sees what you really go through, what you really put in, the effort and the time spent for you to just train and be a chiropractor. I'm pretty sure Deborah as well the same, you know, I mean, for these consultants, I'm pretty sure it takes some training, because anti-aging, you know, you go to South Korea, you see all these plastic surgeons and all these other professions, you see how they do what they do, because they've a lot of training, you know, they learn so much things and it takes a lot of training. And from this, you know, Dr. Khoo, what you share is, it gives us a glimpse of how much, you know, how much one goes through. Everybody goes through, and everybody goes through a journey of their own. And that's why I think I'd like to emphasize here to everybody tuning in, everybody's running their own race, right? So I know this world, we are going through somewhere, we are comparing all the guys doing better than me. She's way ahead of me, but I'd like to just emphasize for those tuning in, we are all running our own race, and we respect each other's profession and what they do. And that's why tonight, it's really important, like, I want to know what Dr. Khoo went through, her chiropractor, because a lot of us say, oh, yeah, chiropractor, I'm pretty sure it's, you know, the mentality for some of us today is just, oh yeah, chiropractor, and just leave it like that, you know. But to really get to understand what you really do wonders is really important in our growth and learning as well. Right, thank you, Yee Jin. So we'll move on to the next question. And, you know, I'm pretty sure there's a lot of chiropractors around, and I'm sure all of you would have different techniques that you're practice. So perhaps you could tell us more of this, you know, the techniques that you're practice, and what do you practice, and who do you cater for, you know, for the audience, or those who are looking for a chiropractor. Yeah, what do you advise as well on this?
Okay, right. So, I think I'll start with introducing, like, there are actually quite a lot of chiropractic methods out there. And even in America, there's a lot more. But in Australia, they narrow down already lah. So the training that I went, the chiropractic university course that I went, they already helped to pick the most make sense one and logical one to be practice on, you know, to help people lah. Okay, So first, if you see the one in red and diversified and gone state, these are well known worldwide. What is diversified? Diversified means literally mixed techniques, diversified. Okay. Gone state is a different kind of level already, that one. That one require, I'll introduce that later. Then we have drop piece, called Thompson technique, and then flexion distraction technique. Maybe you will see on Facebook there's some advertisement. Probably will see what's flexion distraction technique. Then we have activator. Oh no, activator one. This looks ini, jamni, activator. This thing. And then sacral occipital technique and blocks. Then let me come back to this. I like to be. So this is the gone state. Little thing that we use lah. Okay, one of the instrument. That one also actually in America, you actually require like another, like it's like a specialist training also lah. For state, it's just that I kind of squeeze into my class into my flexions because I want to come back to Malaysia lah. Then diversify also, like they do everything lah. You know, cupping also do whatever lah. Okay, neck adjustment when you're lying down. And adjusting a lower back, all this looks pretty similar to gone state as well, but gone state is more about specificity. And then an activator, this is the flexion distraction table. If you see the arrow up and down, right, you see this lever over here means I can actually grab that lever and move up and down. Okay, then if you look at the drop piece here, it looks very like mechanically complicated. I tell you, this table is very expensive. So if your chiropractor charged you expensive, please, it's okay. This thing is about 20k if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, wait, inside secret eh. Okay. And then this is the gone state thing that I want to introduce to you. This is what I mainly practice as well. I do miss certain other things as well. So this is the Novoscope. We check the temperature of the misalignment to find the misalignment, and then we will ask for a full spine x-ray. Then these are my equipments, the gone state benches, and this is the knee chest table, that's the chair, and there's the table behind there. Then so you at least have a picture of what are the chiropractic techniques out there and what do I cater for. So let's get back to that question again. So I mainly practice gone state chiropractic and address mechanical alignment issues. I actually also address muscular issues working together with other fellow health colleagues. I have pictures to show later, and also referral to other practitioners, which I have already done it a few times throughout my practice since my internship until now. At times, I actually get like complicated cases in my practice, and actually ever since in internship, right, a lot like my team, because we have team as well, right? They don't give me complicated cases. I also don't know why. Sometimes I do admit I crack my head. I also don't know what's the answer. But then I learn. That one I learn. I like it. I really like it. Even though I have no answers sometimes. But my lecturer will help me lah. Then I've seen patients who are hyperactive with partial blindness before to help with their bone alignment, not for their blindness and other diseases, mental disease, bipolar, schizophrenia. Well, I tell you, this kind of people, you want to handle them. You need a lot of patience. So this is how my patients have developed. Very character building process. Anxiety and depression. And also like patients with a history of cancer, or they have done surgery for their heart before, things like that. Stroke patient. Only one or two, I think. Osteoporotic patient, older people have osteoporosis, so you just can't just like, you can't just force crack it, okay? You just gotta go with the flow, like, you know, those who experienced my adjustment before, Wendy or Tracy, you know that I'll find the specific place and then I'll just adjust it without any pain. And I have patients with chronic fibromyalgia. What is that? Means this person is quite sad one, this kind of patient. They have pain all over their body. Yeah. Long term. Of course, with such complicated cases, right, I will ensure they are safe to adjust first and also consider whether chiropractic is actually suitable for them. Then these are my fellow colleagues that I partner with, biomechanical analysis, cryotherapy, rehabilitation training and physiotherapy. So mainly all this is about physiotherapy. This center has become a physiotherapy rehabilitation center, and this is the spacious area. So right now, RMCO, we only accept very little people because we want to make sure the cleanliness of the place and hygiene and the safety of not only the patients, also the trainers. Because if the trainers are sick and employed, basically the operation cannot run already, okay? Yeah, and I think, did I miss out anything, Jessie?
Fantastic, I think that really explains. And I think for those tuning in, now you know why you pay expensive. And that's why I think it's really important for everybody. There is certain things that we pay extra for. And I know there's some teaching where, you know, that sometimes they ask you, okay, but come on. I think in respect of people's profession, now that you know, Dr. Khoo has given you an insight to how much that chair costs. So if it costs a lot, you know it's that chair. And and if you understand it, that's the whole reason. It's like buying a car. I can buy a Proton for maybe about, 50,000, but a Mercedes is like 400,000. You're buying the product and you're buying for the machine. So I think that, to me, when you go for this, when Dr. Khoo has given us an insight into that as well, and I'm sure for new skin, for Deborah as well, if you're paying something for that, you're paying for the machine, because those are the technology that helps them do their job well. And I think it's the same for Dr. Khoo as well, So brilliantly explained, Dr. Khoo, and I hope all of you are tuning in and when you watch this, that's a tip for you and you know why you're paying that much as well. So, right, so we get into, before I dive into a last question, because I think this Deborah and Dr. Khoo can give us some insight. But before that, I do have a question from Grace Fu. Grace Fu, would you like to ask Dr. Khoo, or would you want me to read your question out? Okay. I would do the... Oh, yeah. Grace.
Please. Sorry.
Yeah. No worries. Would you like to ask Dr. Khoo your question before I wrap up with the last question after this? Because I think you sent it. Yeah.
Yeah, so I think earlier you mentioned about the pelvic misalignment due to cross-leg, one leg over another. And I think, yeah, that's my question there. Okay, right. Yeah, so are there ways to sort of, I mean, of course, aside going to see a chiropractor, are there ways on a daily basis that maybe this can be corrected or sort of prevented from becoming worse? Yeah.
Okay. That's a very good question. To correct it by yourself is quite impossible because it's already in that position. Okay. If you wanna correct it, you still need a health professional to help you. But if you want to prevent it by yourself, of course, this can be done. It really depends on your sitting posture. So you just have to just avoid, putting the wallet behind your back pocket. And then make sure the seat that you're sitting right is not like on uneven surfaces. And then when you want to cross-leg, it is okay. I actually not super against it. Don't be surprised why I'm not against it compared to other chiropractors. It's because I feel like the timing of you crossing the leg matters. Because if I cross for like a few seconds or 10 seconds, then I misalign my bone, that's quite ridiculous lah, okay? If you can, if you cross leg for a very long time and then as a habit, of course, then that's when it comes in. But if you just like, once a year, maybe like what, 1 month, 5 minutes, then 12 months, that 5 minutes total is just like 60 minutes, right? So it's okay, that one is okay. So don't have to be too paranoid about that one. I feel like that one is a bit too, that one got, when we say don't cross leg, right? I feel like there's a lot more explanation to that lah, Okay, we can be more specific with the advice, I would say. Did that answer your question, Grace?
Yes, thank you.
Great. And I think just to wrap up the question, I think this, the last question, so this was initially, I thought, put this as after the last fifth question, but I think to wrap up, I thought the other question would be better to end it as the last one. And this can be applied, sorry.
Oh, wait, there's one more, the sleeping on the side, that one I haven't addressed. Oh, okay, sorry, yeah. Sleeping on the side, actually, there's no studies to it, but clinical experience, yes. I have a lot of patients who are older, when they sleep certain only just on one side, right? They feel like they don't have pain, but they have tightness. They develop tightness and also restriction in the way they turn their body. So something is stuck already. So means there's misalignment in the joint. Then that's when they come to come and see me and they say, hey, I feel like I sleep wrong or something. Or maybe you just sleep on that side for a very long time. The timing is the determination. That's why only they feel uncomfortable. Okay? Sorry, yes, Jason.
Jason. Okay, before we dive into the last question as well, and this can be given by firstly Dr. Khoo and then our special people who are tuning in, special professionals who are tuning in. Deborah, you could even chip in if you do, because we'd love to have some advice from you. And Susan as well, who is tuning in, you can give us some advice. But before that, I think Dr. Khoo, you have something to announce for the group before we dive into the last final question. Would you like to do that?
Is it the mystery?
Yes, the special announcement that we're going to make for those tuning in before we dive in. But let's make that announcement and then we wrap up with a good word of advice, words of wisdom from both Dr. Khoo and our guests.
Sure. Okay, actually, I surprised, actually Jesse also today only he know lah, okay? Jesse, I have two surprise giveaway for one male audience and one female audience, okay? From Touch of Love florist, Susan, and we will pick the siapa, itu the winner, one of the lucky audience lah, basically, okay? So one male and one female. Actually, one male, then there's only, so what is the mystery gift, Mystery gift is, I mean, there's a hint already, lah. It's from Touch of Love Forest Studio, and then you can figure out a little bit, you know, spend that imagination, so, and also, I just want to announce that you can actually pick up, I announce the name. Am I supposed to announce the name now, Jesse?
No, I don't think we will because I think just to make it easier for Dr. Khoo, we will just announce that you guys will have something, a special gift by Dr. Khoo himself, by Dr. Khoo herself. So yeah. Thank you very much, and Susan, I think, for arranging all of this, you know. Thank you for doing this. It's totally, I think, a surprise for everybody. And what we'll do, I think, just to make it easier for Dr. Khoo, after this session, we will pick the winner and I'll announce it on the group chat for those tuning in. And if we'll just announce it on the group chat, you know. That's that. I hope everybody, that's something from Dr. Khoo. Thank you for doing that again, and Susan, for arranging that. And just to wrap up, I think this is very nice to wrap up, and I hope, you know, for our guests tuning in, Susan, Deborah, Dr. Khoo, you could give us some words of, you know, wisdom or encouragement on this. But firstly, I will just ask you on this, Dr. Khoo, on the last question, which is, and so here's to wrap up, right? Ignore the bracket one, because I think that was already been asked by Grace, you know. But if feel free, I think, Dr. Khoo, I think if you don't mind, feel free if anybody who has any chiropractor questions can be in touch with Dr. Khoo. Some of y'all, if you need the number, you know,
yeah, you can get some good contact.
Yeah. And also for those who are looking for new skin, like now I just look at new skin for anti-aging. I think we just got to also just say, if we're all looking for those kind of products as well, anti-aging, look for her, Deborah, as well. I can't emphasize how much you guys are doing for the industry, you know, this thing, you know. So my question here, which is shown on the screen, so you know, one of the things that comes our way when we're doing a lot of things is challenges, and we are all not exempted, and this is something that I shared with the group. But last week we had our special guest, whom we also asked him the same question: how does he, you know, we all have challenges, and I believe through this experience and how you guys or each individual overcome the challenges is also a way for us to learn and grow, and we get to learn something from one another. So what are the challenges that you guys face for Dr. Khoo as a chiropractor, and for Deborah, you know, as anti-aging consultant? What challenges do you face, and how do you prepare for them or handle it? Any tips or advice you could share with us, or words of wisdom you could share with us?
Okay, I'll share screen. So, okay, I will list three challenges like, because it's more fitted to this period of time. First one is, as a chiropractor, I do face the business aspect in operating a clinic, besides being a sole practitioner. This will be through collaboration and organization. And one of the biggest challenges of everyone's business, the MCO, I was unable to operate for a month for that during this period, and it is really tough. And also, it also challenges my faith. Back to that core value that I've grew up with in church. So this one, this is my first answer: how I weather through it as a sole practitioner, through collaboration with TCM, Rehabilitation Center. Actually Chia is also here, he's a lighting specialist. And basically you need a group of good circle, okay? Good friends, business friends, entrepreneur friends, and also new skin, our anti-aging consultant Deborah, and a video production team. She's not here today, but I actually know some of this connection through my current very active organization that I've been attending, the BNI organization, and I really want to acknowledge that. And a touch of love, Flori's gift. She is also from BNI. And also the last one, last but not least, here is tech services RMKL. Can see, right? Okay. Yeah, then it's very important when you're in a business or whatever, like work or anything, you need a community, you need a group, you need an organization, you need a team, you need someone to, you know, just collaborate together, just hand in hand, you connect the dots together, because you can't do everything, you can't help every single person just by yourself, okay? And next, I've prepared like about 8 points, okay? How do I prepare for it? Okay, number one. Honestly, I feel like social media keeps saying that you have to love yourself, take care of yourself, all this. I think these are very great advice, okay? These are very great advice. This is actually very especially catered for people with who doesn't know how to love themselves, and people who's pretty, you know, they have some issues within themselves. But I need to bring out another point as well. You need to have that heart of willing to serve others than yourself. You should be able to have that criteria of to give and to help others first, okay? I don't know why my screen keeps jumping by itself. And then during this COVID period, I also learned something. We need to sacrifice your life luxury and indulgences and overspending. Honestly, you need to cut costs. This is what I learned. This is truth, okay? And third thing is to say yes to opportunities that are relevant to your business, even if it's free or low cost at the start. Because experiences is what you need. You need the experiences. Experiences is what makes brings more value to you and also as a practitioner, and also helps you to sharpen your leadership skills and other aspects, even your own, for me it's chiropractic skills, obviously. The more patients I see, the faster my diagnosis process will be, because I feel so many bones and muscles already ma. So what is normal, what is abnormal, I touch already, my hands are my eyes basically. For me personally, what's my secret or tips, advice? I reflected, actually when Jesse gave me this question, I reflected back. I was actively involved in church ministries, worship, host team, the Salvation one, I forgot already, the youth one, gatekeeper, something like that, I forgot already. Way ministry. Then Holy Communion also, I also was in there. A lot of things, ushers, all this. Even in Australia, I was involved in ministry as well. Sometimes I like to volunteer driving my, some other people who doesn't have a car, I'm willing to drive them around. I was also involved in organizations like church organization or BNI. Go for volunteering opportunity. I mean, just go all out, you will learn something from other people. Willing to go for a low-wage job as a young teenager and expand life experiences to understand if you are from a very rich family background or rich or middle income even, I really encourage you to go and understand people with low income, how do they feel? And, sometimes we advise in a rich point of view, like, 20 cents only ma, just give it lah, away lah. Okay lah, I mean, yes, we need to have a generous heart. But this is very different from people who maybe their monthly income is only 500 ringgit. Sometimes that 1 ringgit, right, is also important for them, So we really need to understand that psychology aspect as well. And be mentally prepared that mistake can and should happen. It should happen. Because if we we have the advice right from the start, right, and then we don't, because we didn't make mistakes, right, we actually don't learn. We don't learn. Okay? 5, this is what I learned, set realistic. This is what I learned from my brother. He's a CEO of a company. He told me set realistic financial goals for a month first, and once you have achieved that financial, maybe that that price, the amount you want to achieve, then you make sure it's stable for at least 3 months. Then you only bring that financial goal up to another level, because you're not stable yet. You can't just you want maybe, for example, 1,000, then next month you want 2,000, then 3,000, then 4,000. No, you need to make sure it's stable first, okay? Then it will go up gradually like that. Be teachable. Number 6, be teachable no matter what age you are. My family members are my... I'm very, very lucky. I have six or seven people at home. Six adults. They are all in the business line, accounting, auditors. So they're very good with their numbers and everything. I'm the only one who is doing science. So yeah, you can imagine there's a very big difference there. So they are actually my mentors in life and also business. And of course, BNI connection. And I also have a chiropractic mentor, because my skills are the one that people will be convinced of. So I do like marketing all this, but then at the end of the day, my skill will speak everything. I can say very good things, but then if my skin is like that, then whatever I say is just, that's just a thing already. Okay. So it's very important for chiropractors to continue to sharpen their skills. And number 7, be flexible like water, even if it's not part of the plan. It's just that COVID-19 is not part of everyone's plan. no one would have expected this COVID-19 to happen at all. So if you put your water into a water bottle, it will be this shape. If you put in Tupperware, it will follow the shape of the container of that Tupperware. You put in a cup, then you follow the cup shape, the shape. So you just have to learn how to be flexible and adapt through the waves and the tides. Okay? And number eight, I'm still young. I am not a master of my emotion yet. I really admit that, okay? But I'll try not, of course, when I'm a chiropractor, you will see the professional me. But then behind the scene me, right, I'm still a doctor. I also like to be a kid sometimes, you know? Sometimes we don't have to be so serious all the time, right? What I have reflected through this journey is to how to control my emotions and actually always remind myself that coming back to my faith is to commit something that's beyond my control to the Lord and actually trust that God can help me turn it around.
Wow, so good, so good. I just felt like whatever you just shared with us today, like this point, is a reflective of what me and the rest of the group we've covered over the last 9 weeks. We talk about law of growth, and all these are part of those law of growth, failing forward and all. And I think, you know, emotions will be there. We will, and it's okay to be you. Like, I would just, you know, for those, I'm just going to coin it in the term of, even Jesus wept in the Bible. So it's okay to let go of your emotions, but don't let it control you. It's okay to have emotions. It's totally fine, but, you know, but don't let it overcome you. With that said, you know, I'd like to ask Deborah if you like have anything you could share with us, your words of wisdom, because thank you for tuning in. I'm sure Dr. Khoo was, you know, very happy to have you in, and thank you for supporting her, and I'm pretty sure she's you know, very grateful for you to join. And so I think with that, I would like to just ask you as our guest, you know, to or any one of our guests, but maybe start with you, Deborah, then we'll ask Susan if, you know, yeah, anything for you to add. How do we overcome challenges?
Well, thanks for allowing us a chance to say something as well. Hi everyone, I'm Deborah, and as you can see on my screen, I'm an anti-aging consultant from New Skin. Yeah, and Dr. Khoo is one of the sweetest people I know. Yeah, and when we talk about emotions, sometimes when she's telling us about something, I really can see it in her, you know, like she feels whatever she thinks. And I think it's a good thing, actually. It's a plus point. One would think you want a doctor to be like very clinical and, you know, maybe, you know, attend to the matter at hand. But I think this shows she has a heart. So, you know, she will have empathy for the patient. But for myself, in terms of challenges, like, for sure, no one knew that this COVID was going to happen, right? So, but it has kind of spun everyone on their heads, because you're suddenly faced with situations you never imagined, right? So, to me, I agree with what Jin said, is you have to go with the flow, because if you are too rigid, things will come to a point where you can't bend, you know, like about the bamboo and the oak, you know, that one. Yeah, so you need to be able to adjust and face whatever is coming and whatever is there in front of you with an open heart and open mind. And I think it's when you believe in a higher power like God, then you know someone's looking after all that. And then someone once said this, if if there's a situation that presents itself, right, if you can do something about it, it's not a problem. Because you can do something about it. But if you can't do anything about it, it's also not a problem because you can't do anything about it. So you have to leave it to God lah, to handle it. Because you already cannot physically or within your mortal body, you can't do something. So why should you worry? So I think one of the keys to having a relatively stress-free existence is this lah, to understand when it is something you can do something about, and also when it is something you have no way of changing or no way of handling, and yeah, it's beyond you. Yeah. So thank you.
Deborah, so you know, to hear from everybody, I always believe this, and the way how I think I forgot to explain how this axe sharpening came about was through my previous job when I was with this organization called Alpha Malaysia. And basically, Alpha Malaysia, just for some of you to know and tuning in again, it's a Christian non-profitable organization. And I was I learned about this topic or this axe sharpening program through my leader, and if he's tuning in, his name is Abel Chia, and he was from Teach for Malaysia. He was the head coordinator for Teach for Malaysia, and so he instilled that in order to have healthy culture, healthy team culture, he brought this axe sharpening program in. And so I think, you know, to emphasize, to hear what you just said, Deborah, to hear from you, Dr. Khoo, of your advice to us, it means a lot, because this shows that we are willing, this shows that there's so much thing, as you just also mentioned on the chat, there's so much, the learning never stops. We continue learning, right? And every day is a learning process. And even if I'm doing this like for a second time, like I'm running this whole program, even though I ran through the whole thing with my leader, but you're doing it with different people, like different community, different people, you get different kind of response and you get different kind of learning. And so that's why I love what you just said, the learning never stops. And this is why I also emphasize to this group of people who are tuning in, my group, this is why we do what we do, and why you do what you do, and why each and everyone does what you do, is to reinforce and remind you that each of us have a role to play, and also a reminder that each of us, we need to also have some time to pause and reflect and then carry on with our work. So remember, just to, you know, tonight's session is really all about us growing as a team. But really, thank you, Deborah and Dr. Khoo, and maybe Susan, or last few words from your Susan and Kok Wai, if you'd like to share some things, if you'd like to share. If not, don't worry. Would you like to share something, Susan or Kok Wai, on some challenges or any advice for us? Yeah.
Okay. Chia and Susan, yeah. Maybe not, I don't know.
Okay, no worries. I just wanted to open it up if they like to, you know, but no worries.
Hey,
yeah.
Hi.
Yeah, hi. Nice to meet you all. Yeah. I think for me, for what I heard Dr. Khoo mention about learning from her brother who was giving up tips about how you want to survive, you know, about the financial tips, I think that's very useful. I think that really relevant when it comes to the current scenario right now, where current pandemic, that everybody actually need to be prepared for what will be worse, what is far from worse that is coming up, which is because after October, where the moratorium has ended, I think a lot of people will be starting to feel the pinch. And then I think probably by then, most of the businesses will feel the difficult time that is gonna come. Yeah, I think what Dr. Khoo mentioned is really rings a bell, you know, and set small financial goals, short term, and you know, so at least you will cover yourself and you work towards a better financial, you know. Thank you so much, Dr. Khoo.
No problem.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing, Kok Wai. It's good to meet you. And yeah, thank you. So for those of y'all like Dr. Khoo, Kokwai, Susan, and Deborah. Thank you for tuning in. All of you for tuning in tonight. For Dr. Khoo, I will send you some of the slides of my sessions, the law of growth and everything. If you guys like to have a reflect, I'll send the slides to Dr. Khoo. And Dr. Khoo, you can share with Deborah and Kokwai and Susan. These are some of the things that we ran through, the law of growth by John Maxwell, some things by John Maxwell as well, on leadership as well. Maybe, and some of that, as I mentioned, Dr. Khoo has, you know, covered our last 8 weeks of topics, so it's really, really incredible. And for the rest of y'all, thank you for tuning in. We will announce the winner
group chat.
Yes, on the group chat after some discussion. Yeah, we'll announce the winner shortly. But thank you all for tuning in. Thank you once again, Dr. Khoo, for coming on board and share on this, you know, our second live session. And for Deborah and Kokwai and Susan for, you know, supporting Dr. Khoo, as I know her as a friend from church. Thank you for, you know, supporting and tuning in to our program tonight. So once again, thank you everybody, and have a great week ahead. See you.
Thank you.
Thanks. Good night.
Good night, everyone.
Well done. Good night.